And knowing this, shortly Lopes will have to go away. And he's beginning to open it up now. He knows it, the crowd know it, the rest of the athletes in that pack know it. Lopes has got to set off on that lonely vigil fairly soon.
Well, Ron is already putting them under pressure, and that group all of a sudden is now down to about five of them. And there's Carlos Lopes, three Ethiopians and a Kenyan, and they're pulling away from David Lewis in sixth place there. So he must have accelerated on that back straight. He certainly has become positive about the thing, and he's made his mind up that if he's gonna make a great effort to win it, he's gonna make them hurt. And if he doesn't win it, the guy who beats him will know he's been in a race.
Marvelous to see Lopes do this at 38, using all his experience. There's the Ethiopians, they've got to follow. Belcher, Balti, De Bailey, they've got to follow. David Lewis must dig into his resources now for his moment of glory. But at 38, it's all Carlos Lopes doing it exactly right. Mamedi, his challenge burned out and fizzled, and maybe the Portuguese challenge has gone for the team event, because certainly the Ethiopians, the Kenyans, and the Americans are ahead of them now. So it's down to one man, Portugal's lone gold medalist in Los Angeles. He had a hero's welcome home then. He would have an incredible hero's welcome if he made it here. He may well retire soon. He's always been, as Brenda was saying, the great rival to Mamedi. But on big occasions, there's only one super athlete, and that is Lopes, the man who leads now.
Coming up to the 10,000 meter mark in this last lap.
Well, Ron, he finished second in the Portuguese Championships, and I think he did that deliberately in order to get the pressure off himself and onto Mamedi, because he was concerned about Mamedi because he knows his ability. But in 1966, he made his first appearance in the World Cross Country Championship, and here he is in 1985 at 38 years old. And we can hear the crowd are now starting to go crazy. This is the way he runs. This is the way he loves to run. And those Ethiopians will certainly be suffering. But Carlos himself, he's under pressure, but he's putting himself under pressure. This may be his last brave effort in any major event. And he'll know it, and he'll know how important it is to try and win this one.
Indeed, he will. He's done everything absolutely right. And he must be thinking now that having won the Olympic title, he'll be the first man to win the IAAF cross-country title three times. He's doing it at 38. He's tuned himself to perfection for this day in front of his home crowd. And the Portuguese got it right. This was the day to stage the championship. He really has run quite magnificently, and everyone from the crowd are closing on this race because they want to cheer him home. Mamedi finished a long while ago. David Lewis has been burned off. There are three, look at that. That's what he's doing to the world's best cross-country runners, to Balcher, to Balti, to De Bailey, and the best of the Kenyans. They can't go with him. At 38, this is truly an astonishing run. Carlos Lopes. John Tracy's back there. Christoph Hurler's gone. All the rest are struggling. 381 is the one Kenyan there, but Lopes, the news has got around to the crowd. The gap is opening up, and Lopes is on his way to a truly remarkable victory.
He's the only man, too, Ron, to break a total domination by the African countries in both the junior men's race and this one, too. He's followed by a host of Africans, then the Americans, and the rest of this very, very powerful field.
Well, what an inspiration is, Ron. He's actually older than me, and that makes me feel bad, because I should be out there running and not sitting over here in the commentary box. But I'm talking about it being an inspiration. At 38 years old, he'll give almost a generation of middle, long-distance marathon runners and cross-country runners the opportunity to go out on their own and train and think, he's 38, he's world cross-country champion and Olympic champion. Maybe I should hang on for another 6 years.
As Brendan Foster leaves the commentary box to get back into training, so Carlos Alberto de Jesus Lopes comes in, and they're climbing over the rails to get a closer look at this man as he comes home to what is now a truly remarkable victory. Behind him, he's got Balti and Balcher and Kipkoech and De Bailey, and they couldn't face up to the finishing pace, and it really has. He's stretched them, he's unwound it, and he really has done it truly magnificently. Used all his experience. Fourth in Athens in the 1982 European Championships, sixth in those 1983 World Championships at Helsinki. Then came his magnificent run, all the time keeping up the standard of cross-country running, but the magnificent run in the marathon, 2 hours, 9 minutes and 6 seconds. And remember, he was knocked down by a car 10 days before Los Angeles. There's John Tracy trying to get away from Balcher. There's Christoph Perla. And 22 is Bunur of Algeria. But this is the man on his way to victory. 400 meters from the finish. And he's getting better. The gap is growing. Lopes, the PA commentator, has lost his voice. And the crowds are lining the track. 38 last month. His wife, Teresa, his two children, Nuno and Pedro, two boys will be here. What a great day. What a day to get it all right. Portugal may have lost the team title, but they've won a truly remarkable individual race. Kipchoge will get second, then the first of the Ethiopians. They will battle out the team title, but this man is on his way to a most remarkable individual victory. A victory that will take him to the line. 50 yards clear of Kipchoge. And Portugal goes wild. And now the gap grows. The second Ethiopian home, John Tracy, is home in fifth place. One more Ethiopian than Christoph Perla. Then the first of the Algerians. And the Americans fizzling out, but maybe passing a little better. 1, 2, 3, and the lead is over the line, so he hasn't done so badly. Pat Porter is through, Ed Eystone is through.
I've got it.
Lito of Portugal, so they're still packing well. And it looks as though David Lewis will be the first Briton home in 18th place as he crosses the line now. Well, after that tremendous battle between the men, the unofficial is
full of fight, and he's looking as well as I've seen men finish marathons for a long, long time. He really is looking magnificent for the pace that's been run. Look at this.
That last mile, by the way, was 4 minutes, 40 seconds. So the last 5 miles, 4.57, 4.47, 4.38, 4.41, 4.40. And at the moment, he's should be about 2 hours, 9 minutes, 40 seconds. Unless he speeds up even more. Lopes on his way into the stadium. And shortly into the shadow of the tunnel leading into the Coliseum Bowl.
And not only has the temperature dropped, but he's in the cool. 1.2 kilometers to go. And they're looking over their shoulders, and it's Nzao behind them. But their gap, the gap between them and Lopes, is about the same as them and the next man following them. So these two must know that if they can survive now, they're on for medals.
What a battle this is going to be. They're not looking forward to the torture of that last lap, but it's silver or bronze for one of them. But they're going to have to fight for it.
Well, David, Carlos Lopes is about to experience the Olympic dream, but Charlie Spedding and John Tracy are about to experience a little bit of an Olympic nightmare, because after 26 miles and you come into the stadium and you think, oh goodness, I'm gonna have to sprint around this track to get a silver or a bronze medal. They'll be happy with whatever medal they get. They both deserved it, but what a race that's gonna be for third place. Beginning of the year, Charlie Spedding hadn't even run a marathon, and now after his performance here, he's already gonna go down in the record books as one of the best performances in an Olympic marathon by a Briton, and that is absolutely fantastic. But they're looking tired. They both seem to have suffered the strain. And I wouldn't know who to bet on in the sprint, because they're neither of them are the fastest men in the world.
Well, it looks as if Charlie Spedding settled to drop in behind John Tracy and trying to take him in the closing stages. He seemed to deliberately drop back there in behind him. And you can always gain a very slight advantage at all distances with that first attack. But you have to time it right. and at the end of 26 miles, 385 yards, when is the right time? So, the Olympic champion of 1984 disappears in the shadows of the tunnel, shortly to emerge in this vast arena, and John Tracy is not waiting. John Tracy has made his bid, and Charlie Spedding has now about 10 metres adrift. And here is the Olympic champion in the marathon for 1984, Carlos Lopes of Portugal. The cross-country champion of the world, the second fastest man in history at 10,000 metres, an athlete who's been near the top of the international list for nearly 20 years. John Tracy, the former international cross-country champion, being chased by Charlie Spedding for the silver medal.
And I don't think that chase is finished yet, David. I think Charlie's still got a glint in his eye. I think he prefers silver to bronze. I think it's going to be a cracking run, and it's going to be an emotional scene when they come inside this Olympic Coliseum.
John was perhaps the one more uncertain of his finish and made that bid very early outside the stadium. We still have to see what sort of gap he's got. Just the finishing straight to go for Carlos Lopes. Well inside 2 hours, 10 minutes. And Lopes, 37 years old, takes Olympic gold and a new Olympic best time. But now, what about the race for silver and bronze?
And doesn't he look fit and well?
Will it be Tracy? Will it be Spedding? Look, there's about 10 metres difference, but that's the difference between silver and bronze. Spedding is trying to close, but it's not going to happen. The green vest of Ireland, worn by John Tracy, who takes the silver medal. And for Great Britain, a fine bronze for Charlie Spedding of Gateshead Harriers.
Magnificent. The first three in that race, pretty much against the odds. Sentimental favourites they may have been, but there were many, many better favourites in the field. And Carlos Lopes, who's done it all on the track, all on the country, comes good in his third ever marathon. And as a
medaille d'or, representant le Portugal.
Winner of the gold medal, representing Portugal, Olympic champion Carlos Lopes.
Carlos Lopes. The gold medal to Carlos Lopes of Portugal. In an epic marathon. Primo Nebbiolo, the president of the IAAF, presenting that medal. And what a remarkable one for Portugal, their first ever in track and field. And we think he's the oldest gold medalist in track and field at
Medaille
these games.
Medaille d'argent, representant l'Irlande.
Winner of the silver medal.
What a celebration from Ireland, John Tracy, Olympic in his first ever marathon. Takes the Olympic silver medal. Battling with Charlie Spedding until the final mile in what will always be remembered as one of the great Olympic marathons. The mudlark. And Charlie Spedding. His third marathon only. He runs within a second of his lifetime best in all that blistering heat.
Charles Spedding.
And steps up for his bronze medal now. Hugh Jones, another British competitor, finishing in 12th place in 2 hours 13:57, and Jeff Smith did not finish on this occasion.